you enjoyed during various methods of subtraction, right? So now quickly we will be doing a mental math game. Okay, I will be asking you questions and you need to solve along with me and give me the answer. So shall we begin? Okay, here it goes. Now there is a girl called Pari and she bought 7 bananas for herself. She was feeling very hungry and she ate 2 out of them. So how many bananas were remaining with her? So what we need to do is, first we need to draw 7 bananas. We can do with either method, children. We can do either with the striking method or we can do with the beads method. So here I am doing it with the striking method. Okay, so I will draw here 7 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now Pari was very hungry, right? So she ate how many bananas? She ate 2 bananas. I striked off 2 bananas and I drew here 2. So what is the balance left with her? Can we count? It's 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So the number of bananas which Pari had with her finally was 5. So I need to draw here 5 lines. Okay, so 7 when subtracted with 2 will give me an answer 5. Clear? Were you able to solve along with me? Great. So shall I ask you the next question? Okay, fine. So here it goes. Mani bought 6 eggs with him. Okay, while he was bringing the eggs, 3 eggs broke. So what is the balance eggs which he has with him? So what happened? Here Mani was having 6 eggs, right? So what we will do here? We will draw 6 eggs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now in this, how many eggs broke off? 3. 1, 2 and 3. What will I do? I will circle this 3. So what is the balance x which is remaining with Mani? It is 1, 2, 3. So Mani has 3 eggs remaining with him. Okay. So what did we learn here? 6 when reduced by 3 will give me an answer 3. Okay. The next question. Tendril is 8 years old. Okay. And her sister Nila is 2 years younger than her. So what is the age of Tendril? Tendril is 8 years old and she had a sister whose name was Nila, and Nila is 2 years younger than her. What do you mean by younger? She is smaller than her. Nila is smaller than her. So what is the age of Nila now? What we will do? Again, shall we do it with the bead method here? We tried with the striking method, line method. We tried with the circling method. Now shall we do again with the bead method? Okay. So now Tendril was 8 years old. So we will draw 8 beads here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Her sister Nila is how old younger than her? 2. So we will strike off 2. So what is the age of Nila now? Shall we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So Nila is 6 years old. Okay. Is it clear, children? So did you all enjoy doing the maths? Okay, fine. Now I have one more question to shoot with you. Okay. Now suppose if I have been given number 8, 5 and 3. Suppose if I have these 3 numbers with me and I need to put it in the subtraction form. Say if I put like this, so can you just find out which number will be placed here, which will come first? Can you tell, children? Very good. As I told you in the beginning of the class itself, that always the largest number will come in the first place. So what will come here? 8. Right. So In both the places, the largest number will come first. What is the next number? If I write here 5, then what will be here? See, we can do it with the striking method here. I have 8, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And if I reduce 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Say if I strike out 5. So what is the balance? 1, 2 and 3. So what is my answer? 3. So what will come here? 3. Right. Similarly, now if I do here 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I reduce it with 3. 1, 2, 3. And I strike here 3. So what is the balance left with me? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So answer is 5. So if I write here 8 minus 3 will give me an answer 5. Is it clear, children? So what did you understand in this? That the greatest number will always come in the front, in the first place. Okay? And then if 8 when reduced by 5 will give the number 3. Similarly, 8 when reduced by 3 will give the number 5. I hope you enjoy doing this. Very good. Now children, we will be doing a quick recap of what we learnt in addition and subtraction. I hope you would have understood where should we use the symbol plus and where we should use the symbol minus. For addition, we use the symbol plus, which means to add, and for subtraction, we use the symbol minus, which means to less down. Okay, so shall we start the sums? I will give you the sum and you need to tell me whether we need to add that particular sum or do we need to subtract it. Shall we begin? Okay, see here. Now, in this question, 3, if added or subtracted will give us 5, shall we just try? I have 3 fingers in one hand, I have 2 in another hand. So what will happen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which means that if I add this, it will give me an answer 5. Shall we try with the next sum? Now, 4, 2, 2, right. So what will happen? Now, if I take 4 in one hand and I take 2 in one hand, what is the answer I get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. But what is the answer given for me? It is given as 2, which means that 4 if I have in my hand, and if I reduce 2, what is the balance left? 2. So here I need to put a minus symbol. So 4 when reduced by 2 will give me an answer 2. Shall we try with the next question? 8, 3, 5. Okay, now I will keep 8 fingers in my hand. Say if I add 3, 9, 10, 11. What is my answer given? It is given as 5. So which means that my addition will not work out here. So what I need to do? If I have 8 fingers and I remove 1, 2 and 3. So what is the balance? 5. So what I need to do here, children? I need to put here a minus again. So which means 8 when reduced by 3 will give me an answer 5. Shall we do with the next one? Now 3 equal to 6. So what we will do? I will take 3 in one hand and I will take 3 in another hand. Shall we add? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is the answer given for me? 6. So which means what will come here? It will be addition. I need to add the sum. Okay. Coming to the next one. 9, 2, 7. I will have 9 fingers in my hand. Okay. Now, if I add 2, 10, 11. What is my answer given? Answer is 7. Which means addition will not work out here. Same thing, if I keep 9 fingers in my hand and I reduce to 1, 2. What is the answer left? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Which means what? What should I do here? I need to put here a minus sign. Which means that 9 when reduced by 2 will give me an answer 7. Okay. The last one, 2, 6, 8. I will have 6 fingers in my hand. If I add 2, 7 and 8, I get the answer 8. And what is the answer given? It is 8. So what we will do here, children? We will be putting an addition. So 2 when added with 6 will give me an answer 8. So the last question, we will be doing the addition. I hope, children, you enjoyed this particular class of addition and subtraction and you enjoyed doing all the practice questions with me.